Hi, we're gonna see how a piece works inside music. Let's open this piece, Symphony 6. The main advantage of using music for the pieces is that you can combine multiple files within the same piece. So the piece conceptually is here defined as a folder. It's a folder of display files, but it's also a folder where you can combine media files. So here I have a combination between PDFs and MP3, MP4, and even YouTube links. Meaning that I can be on the cello part, but then in one click, jump to the flute one part. You can see first that to flip pages, you simply need to tap on the left and right side. You can also connect the iPad with a Bluetooth loop pedal to turn pages hands-free. To activate the toolbars, you need to tap in the center of the screen. Here, you will have all of the functionalities and information to use this piece. Let's say you're performing and you don't want to flip pages and be bothered by the center of the screen. We developed the performance mode, meaning that once you activate the locker and you click in the area of the piece, you will not be disturbed by the toolbars around it. And to exit it, you simply need to click on the cross right here. Now you can also navigate within your piece by clicking on the thumbnails and really going exactly where you want to go with the page numeration. Let's say you want to structure your piece with different movements, you simply need to open the bookmarks and create your own. Inside the piece, you'll access all of the features. Let's open some of them. Annotate. This is the place where you're gonna make some markings inside the piece. Let's exit the annotation and, for instance, open the rearrange mode, where you can play with the different pages and add new ones. You also have the page turn option, the export option, the crop one, etc. If you want to use the metronome, there is an embedded one inside music. What's really cool in this feature is that you can both activate just the sound, but also make it visible around the screen. Let's turn it off. Also, if your piece is inside a set list, you can jump from one piece to another one easily by just clicking on the other one. Here, I will go back to Symphony 6 and show you that I can also jump to the other piece by clicking on the arrows. So here, at the bottom of the toolbar, you'll see that I can have all of my videos MP3. I can add new ones by just clicking on the plus button. I can access them from the drive, but also directly from YouTube. I already did it, and I will open and activate my YouTube video, which is right here. So when I click it, it's a real combination between the score and the video. I can enjoy the play bar, and by pressing it, I will activate the YouTube video while reading my music. So I will move forward a little bit, and then I can read, study my music while seeing the video. At any time, I can simply unactivate it and, for instance, put another media file, an MP3.